I never had a taste for this sort of thing, but I must admit, I'm deeply enjoying the suit.
Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to John's Marlowick, and today we got Iron Man, issues 83 to 86. Now we've already got the premium base stage 11 on my channel, so today we got a lot of details for the torso, and we actually put the torso together. I'll show you how I'm going to do that. It's a little bit different than the magazine. Well, there we go. Look, some of it looks a little bit fiddly, but not many issues left now. I'm not exactly sure which issue completes the actual model when we do put it all together. I think it's around about 94, 95. I don't know what we're going to do with the last five, to be honest, but because the stand is virtually complete. I think we only need two more panels, two more light strips, and that is it. That is done. And it was the big rod to hold it together, so maybe that is part of it. I'll have to have a look at somebody's video. There's a young man I have a look at on the Italian sites, and he's well ahead. I think he's finished his now. So anyway, let's have a look at what is in 83. There we go. So issue 83, we've got the rear right shoulder plate, the upper right flap, the lower right brake fin, and the lower right flap. Now 84 is the left side, so basically, yeah, we put that foil together with this plate, and then we put that piece with that. It's a hinge, and then eventually we will put it on the model itself. And here on the exploded view, it shows you exactly where it goes. Excellent. Anyway, 84 is exactly the same. We'll have a look at 85 and 86 later. Okie doke, here we go. Issue 83. Okie doke, those are the parts. Okay, let's pop them to one side. First of all, we've got this foil. As you can see, it's got creases there and there. And we need to bend this up 90 degrees. Get a straight edge there like that. Use tweezers or pliers. Get them at 90 degrees. Then I can fit it later. Something like that. There we go. Excellent. Now what we need are these two pieces. You can marry these up there like that, and then this will go there, and we do need is this piece which will capture it all. So that's where them are important to be 90 degrees, and that will go them a little bit more. Should do it. Pull out there like that. And then we can capture these with a screw. It's still not bent right. There we go. Get that in. Just like that. And we need to put a screw. Okay, we need SP screws for this. One at either end. Hopefully this isn't going to give us much trouble, but you never know with these things. It's a little bit fiddly. I think that is lined up nicely. So I'll put the first screw in. No, that's not going to hold it. Right, I'm going to take that. Keep it stable. Okay, I've employed a little bit of tape for this. Let's tap that screw there. And there we go. That shouldn't be too tight, but it is obviously too tight now. So I'll just slacken that off. So that should be up there anyway. Take the tape off and then we'll try this out. So that piece there should come up. There we go. And this piece should be free enough. There we go. Excellent. So that pops there and that pops there. That looks brilliant. A little bit fiddly. Well, there we go. 84 is exactly the same. And here we have the parts for 84 YSP screws. Again, we need to fold these two parts up. And then we need to put these two pieces together like so, and then this will go on here. Yep, something like that, as long as it lines up with the hole, the screw hole, and this piece sits over the top, as long as that brake pin doesn't get in the way. There we go, like that. There we go, we can see the hole. Now we just need the screws. Let's make sure that brake pin is lined up, which it isn't at the moment. Well, unfortunately, that one has broken that fin. That piece fell off, and then this piece has broken off. So, unfortunately, 84 is broke. Okay, guys, so issue 83 is perfectly good. As you can see, the fin is perfectly fine. That'll fold into there, no problem. You can manipulate that whichever way you want as well as. Issue 84, I managed to repair it. That comes fine, the fin stays on, no problem. With the help of a little bit of super glue. But obviously I'm going to have to reorder issue 84. But that is one way of not doing it. Basically, I think it was the, well, obviously it was these two pieces that fell off. I was probably a little bit too clumsy with the tweezers. Either that or just unlucky. But issue 83, like I said, is perfectly good. But I'm annoyed with myself, I really am. There we go. I can still put these on the torso anyway once we've finished 85 and 86. So I'll pop them to one side for now. As you can see, there's no damage whatsoever to 84. Just that. And I know it will stay on now, but anyway, let's get on with 85. There we go, issue 85. We have the right spoiler, the right upper brake fin, IP screws, TP screws, upper left brake fin, and the left spoiler. And basically we do the same again without breaking them, of course. And we add them to 83 and 84. Okay, so those are the parts. Let's get them out. Okay, those are the parts. That's the right spoiler and the right fin, and the left spoiler and the left fin, and TP and IP screws. So first of all, let's put these to one side. We need this one, and we need to bend this again without breaking it. There we go, eventually. Okay, now what we need to do is put that on the left one. That's the right one on that one. I think them instructions are wrong. Just give us a sec. Yeah, that one's correct. The instructions are wrong. Identifying this piece and this piece. This one does say L on it, but when you look at the instructions, where they've laid it out, they say this is the right one. But it's not, luckily, it has got an L on it. That is the right fin, which goes there like that. So I need 83. Okay, now we've got 83. I think this is the correct one. Let me just check. Yeah, this is the good one. That piece goes there. I should sit flush so we can see the screw holes, but we can't fully see the screw holes because that needs rubbing down. The stuff on there that needs cutting off. I'll give it a minute. Show me first anyway. There we go. You can just see that roughness there. That's stopping it from making a good contact, but making the hinge unworkable. The screw will just go into the plastic. Excellent. That's taken the roughness off there. You can see it all there on the file as well, all that red. So that should now join up with that one, which it seems to do. So I should be able to get a screw through there now. Pull that through there. And then let's screw it away. There we go. Excellent. I think that fin, we should be able to, there we go, pull that around. Yep. There we go. That is 83. Looking just like that. Oh, it was brilliant. Now we need to do the same with 84 with this piece. So again, I need to, yep. There we go. That then goes on there, like that. There we go. And we need this one, which is the, like that, has got, see if that makes any difference. Just couldn't see the screw hole in the other one, so it was pointless trying to force it. And this one, my fin's moved back forward, rather, I should say. Right, so we can fit a screw through there. Nope, that's not the way through. I'll have to get rid of some roughness on the end there. Okay, now this one will screw through now. Now we've got rid of that rough edge. I'll also apply some tape to keep that brake fin in position. Pop the screw down and it does seem to be taking hold. Yep. Okay, well, let's take the tape off. Okay, well, let's have a look at this piece there. That can go there, that fin can go there, that one can go there, and this one, that's a little bit too tight for it. There we go, that's moving a bit freer now. The screw isn't as tight, but at least now I can move it around. This side was just a nightmare, this one. That moves. There we go. But obviously I'm going to order this piece again. Because of that brake, well, yeah, like because of that brake fin. But that's how that piece looks like. Okay, now we've got the torso and we can fit these two pieces. This one on this side, just there, like that. And we have one IP screw. Excellent. Now we can put the other piece just there. There we go. That's them two pieces in place. So that will lift up like that. There we go. That piece there, that piece there. If you sort of want to do that anyway. That piece there and that piece there. Just like that. Side view. Let's do an overhead view. There you go. That looks excellent. It's a pity that fin broke. And there's another look. Excellent stuff. Okay, now we've got issue 86. We got a right back plate, a left back plate, the upper breast plates, left interior detail and right interior detail, and a pectoral detail left and right with IM screws. Now this is the issue where we put the two chest pieces together, and here they actually inform you to use cotton on the end of here. Well, basically we don't need any cotton, because if you take these two rings off, this one and this one, yeah, I can't take mine off, you can actually put these two pieces together by looking down through here. Let me show you. Now, I've done this a few times already. Basically the hole is there that we're aiming for. Putting the two pieces like this, you can actually see where the rod is all the time, and you can just using gravity direct it into place. Yep, that's got it now. Then that won't slot together, and there you go, you can see it just there popping through. Excellent stuff. And this will just squeeze together. Now the problem I did have with this when I tried it a few times was positioning it, not the rod, but getting this piece married up with this piece, the front part with the back part. And here, as you can see how it's a little bit rough, it's simply because this neck support here was interfering, and here wasn't slotting, this piece wasn't slotting into this neck support. Yeah, so as you can see, that's moved over now, so it should squeeze together. That was my problem anyway. There we go. As that piece all back together, the only problem would be here probably. This clip. Yeah, that slot there. Yeah. That neck piece kept falling out. But as you can see, that's closed up nicely now. So just make sure you get that slot into the hole here, and it's all lined up. Well, that's perfect now. But you can see what I mean. With that off, you can actually see. I might not be able to see it on this camera, to be honest. But you can actually see into here, to there, where it slots in. So you don't need cotton. There, we can just screw that together. Excellent stuff. Well, first of all, I better get the parts out. And here are the parts for issue 86. There we go, those are all the parts. Pectoral details and other details, but we need the IM screws now. Screw these two chest pieces together. Chest pieces together. So we need this. And need to lift that out of the way and that out of the way. That fin. And we got two IM screws, one down here. There we go. That's looking brilliant now. Fantastic. There we go. We only need to put them two shoulder gear rings back in place. And there we go, those are the details in place. That one, and that one, that one, and that one. I've only loosely fit them because I've got to take it all off again. But that is how they should go, like that. Those are the positions for them. So that's brilliant. Well, I hope that saved you some thread. So there we go, guys. That is that. That is 83 to 86. And I know I've got to replace 84, so I've only loosely fitted the last pieces of detail in there. This piece and these two pieces for the pecs, I think they come on in a later issue. Keep pieces 86C and 860 and 86E safe for assembly in future issues. So I'll keep that in there and there, and that in there and there. But yeah, all I need to do is put them rings back on. There we go, those are those rings. I kept the screws separate, obviously. Oh, attached to them, I should say. There we go. So take them off, and then you can see inside. And you can see where that rod is going to end up. It makes it a lot easier than cotton filling about, wrapping cotton on it and then pulling it through. Because at the end of the day, you've still got this slot here that you've got to get over, and sometimes that can be difficult. Also, I found here and here, these two mounting points here and here. There we go. So here and here can be a little bit difficult in getting them to slot in. So make sure they're not bent, because if they are, then you need to force them straight somehow. But they could be a problem. And like I said earlier, the neck piece, there we go. You can see the neck piece there. How I've roughed it up here, basically the paint was stopping it from pushing in. It only goes in by a millimeter or so, but that was causing a lot of problems as well, lightening it all up. But now it's fantastic. So there we go. Okay, guys, well, that is it. 83 to 86 complete. Now before we go, let's check out this reactor. There we go, she lights up, no problem. Yeah, there you go. You know that rod and that switch works. Brilliant. Looking at this foil as well, I think I could actually take it off without actually dismantling it all. So that's unky dory. Just order 84 again and we're back on track. Absolutely loving this build. It looks superb. It really does. But anyway, that is it for another month. So if you did like that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you next month for the next four issues. What are we on, 87 to 90? Ooh, not many to go now. Excellent. But anyway, thanks for watching. Take care and stay safe. Bye for now.